Hey, this is Dr. Barry. For the next few minutes, let's discuss some tasty treats that you can use to make your ketogenic meals even tastier. So many people, when they're coming to keto, they're not sure what's okay to eat, what's okay not to eat. Can I use ketchup? Can I use mustard? What about mayo? What about salt and pepper? And so I wanted to make a quick video today and tell you my seven favorite ketogenic condiments. These condiments are delicious. They're relatively cheap. They're either easy to find or they're easy to make at home. And that's something I want you to consider as I'm talking about each one of these, is you can make these at home typically for pennies, and it tastes better than anything you can get at the store. You are 100% aware of and responsible for the ingredients, which is a very good thing. And it's quite possible you might find some new favorites as you go through my list. One of the things that happened to me on my ketogenic journey is that I tried flavors I'd never tried before. I grew up in a small southern United States town. And so if you had said the words hollandaise sauce to me, or aioli, or vinaigrette, I wouldn't have known what you were talking about. All I knew about was ketchup and mustard. And so as I've went down this road, I've learned about new condiments and new flavors, some of which were weird to start with, but which I wound up loving now and absolutely adore on my ketogenic meals. So let's go through this list. If you know someone who's new to keto who could use some help with the flavors, with the condiments, little adding things you can add to your meals to make them even more tasty, please share this video with them. Send it in an email and a text message. You can even share it in your keto or low carb groups. Now let's talk about this. Number one, the easiest and my favorite probably is butter. You can put a little butter on anything from sauteed asparagus to steak, and it makes it better. It raises the amount of good, healthy fats you're getting in your ketogenic diet. It's a win-win. You just can't beat butter, and that's why it comes in number one. Butter has zero total carbs unless it's been adulterated by something. And so butter is a gift from the Creator, and you should use it daily. Number two, bacon grease. You could probably guess this is going to be my number one or number two. I absolutely love bacon grease. And in the South, there used to be this delicacy salad that my grandmother would make. She would take dark green leafy vegetables and even pick watercress, which grew wild behind our house. And she would get bacon grease very hot and add some salt and spices with it. And then she would pour the hot bacon grease over the salad, and it would wilt the salad. And everyone loved that. And then I find out years later, this is also a trick that some of the top chefs in the world use to make delicious greens. So bacon grease is full of good, healthy fats. It's not just saturated fat, as you may have heard. It has a wide variety of good, healthy fats that nourish your body. It has 0 grams of total fat, which is also a bonus. You can use it liberally and not worry about bumping up your carbs at all. Number three is vinaigrette. Now, vinaigrette is something I didn't know about growing up because it wasn't ketchup or mustard. I did not know there was anything else except those two and maybe some mayonnaise, but that was gross when I was a kid. I didn't want to eat that. But vinaigrette, I found, can be a zero-carb condiment. It's very, very simple to make at home. It costs pennies to make. It'll stay very fresh in the refrigerator for 1 or 2 weeks after you make it. And it's delicious on many things, not just on salad. So if you're not into eating 7 to 10 cups of salad a day, you can use your vinaigrette on other things. If made properly, vinaigrette comes in at 0 grams of total carbohydrates. Number four, mayonnaise. Now, you have to be careful with mayonnaise, right? You can buy mayonnaise at the store that has 0 grams of carbohydrates, but it's also made of soybean oil or canola oil, and you don't want that. There are some big manufacturers now who are making mayo that's almost zero carb, if not zero carb, making it out of olive oil or avocado oil. And I'll put a link down below to a good mayo that's made with avocado oil that has essentially 0 grams of carbohydrates. And then mayo comes in at worst, if you just buy one of the over-the-counter kinds, you're going to have 1 gram of total carbs per serving. If you make it at home, you can get that very, very close to 0 grams of total carbs per serving for your mayonnaise. Number five is hollandaise sauce. growing up in the South, I had no idea that this existed. It is a liquid heaven that you can put on your eggs. It goes great with meat and many other things. It's also great over sauteed asparagus if you eat vegetables in your diet. If made properly, hollandaise sauce takes minutes to make. And I really want you to make that part of your keto journey. I want you to try new things in the kitchen. It doesn't mean you have to slave over the stove for 8 hours to make a meal. You can make hollandaise sauce as good as any French chef in minutes. And then you can keep it in the fridge for up to a week. It's delicious. If made properly, you can get hollandaise sauce down to 2 grams of total carbs per serving, and it's full of healthy, delicious, wonderful fats and more flavor than you might have imagined could ever exist in a sauce. Number 6 is ranch dressing. Now, if you just buy any ranch off the shelf, it's almost assuredly going to have soybean or canola oil in it. You want to avoid those industrial seed oils. You can make your own ranch dressing at home in minutes for pennies. That has at worst 2 grams of total carbs per serving, full of good healthy fats. Okay, so I want you to Google this, look it up on YouTube, and watch how to make hollandaise sauce and ranch dressing. If you make the ranch dressing and then you blend in some full fat sour cream, now you have ranch dip. Still very, very low carb, 2 or 3 grams of total carbs per serving. Pretty cool. Number 7 is my personal favorite when it comes to red meat, and that's mustard. It's really hard for big food to mess with mustard much. They might add a little bit of maltodextrin or something like that, but mustard at its worst is about 2 grams of total carbs per serving. And so you can use mustard if you love that flavor on your meat. You can use it pretty liberally. And then number 8, a bonus one, even though this is Title 7, I'm going to give you an extra one because it's aioli. And aioli deserves to be on this list. If you like garlic, aioli is for you. If you don't like garlic, you need to try it again. Okay, I'm not an advocate of eating lots and lots of garlic, but a little garlic for flavor is divine. Aioli, if made properly, takes minutes, will store in your fridge for a week or two, and comes in at 2, maybe 3 grams of total carbs per serving. And all of my serving sizes that I talk about here are very liberal. So you don't have, I'm not talking about a tenth of a teaspoon. I'm talking about a good serving so you can really enjoy the flavor of these condiments. Now, of the ones you've tried, I want you to put in the comments, what's your very most favorite keto condiment? And then also, I want you to promise Dr. Barry that you're going to try at least one, if not two of these. I want you to make them at home if you've never done it. And I want you to try one that you've never tried in your life. And if you're like me and you've never heard of béarnaise sauce or hollandaise sauce or aioli in your life, Google it, watch a YouTube video, then make it at home and surprise your family with this explosion of delicious flavor on their keto meal. Now, if you enjoyed this video, please click that subscribe button and the little bell right beside it. So every time I have a bright keto idea or otherwise, you'll be one of the very first to know. Also, follow me on Instagram because I'm always trying to put out great content there and help people on their keto journey. This is Dr. Barry. I'll see you next time.